about one mas'ala about the meaning of the knowledge and what is the meaning of the knowledge and how to take the knowledge and bayan fadl al-ilm, which is the superiority of the knowledge. This is not my talk. I'm going to read what Imam Ahmad ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned in his fatawa. قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله العلم ثلاثة أقسام. The knowledge or getting knowledge three types. علم or knowledge three types. Number one, العلم بأسماء الله وصفاته. العلم to know about the names of Allah and the good attributes of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And this is first thing you have to get it from knowledge. Allah said in the Quran, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. It's عقيدة. You have, if you want to teach somebody about Islam, somebody say he became Muslim. You want to teach him Islam. How to start with him? Start with عقيدة. Don't go tell him pray. And you know, Sahaba, they used to do. That doesn't work like that. No. You have to talk about Allah first. Asma Allah, the names of Allah. Who's Allah? You know, this is the main thing. Because most of these people, they, you know, they sit partners beside Allah, even Jewish or Christian, you know. Or whatever, any kind of thought, I can't say deen, it is not deen. It is عقيد, it is thought, معتقد, يعني, what they say. The point here is you have to start that with this first part of knowledge, teaching people what? عقيدة. Who's Allah, the names of Allah, the attributes of Allah. This is the main thing. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent some surah in the Quran talking about, especially that surah Makki surah. It's talking about عقيدة mostly. Like for example, قل هو الله أحد. This surah, third of the Quran, one third of it. If you read it, Allah gonna reward you like exactly as if you read one third of the Quran. Because it's talking about the attributes of Allah. One of the Sahaba, he used to lead the Salah and he used to recite that surah all the time. قل هو الله أحد. And the Sahaba, they complain. Why you gonna say? There are too many surahs in the Quran. He said, because this surah talking about the attributes of Allah. And I love it. And Rasulullah said, Allah loves you because you love the surah. You get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the surah is talking about the attributes of Allah. Number two, after knowing, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And then وَاسْتَغْفِرِ الذَّنْبِكِ. استغفر الذَّنْبِكِ means action. You have to know the عقيدة first. Number two, القسم الثاني, العلم بما أخبر الله سبحانه وتعالى. You have to know whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the past, in the future, and in the present time, it is in the Quran. For example, in the past, the qasas al-anbiya, the stories of the prophets, and the Fir'aun, Qarun, Ad, Thamud, everybody before us, Bani Israel, this is, you have to know about it. Al-Quran is talking about something going to happen in the future, but we did not know it yet. لَا تَنْقَضَ عَجَائِبُ. Too many things in the Quran we did not know anything about it. Even the Quran is talking about something in the future, talking about the clouds, talking about the bottom of the ocean, talking about too many things, but now even our scholars, they did not know it. Nobody can claim he's making tafsir to the Quran Kareem. Nobody can claim, he said, I'm mufassir. Nobody mufassir. We have, I study Manhaj al-Mufassirin, that book called Manhaj al-Mufassirin, the methods of tafsir or the Mufassirin, Al-Qudama, and the Mu'asirin, the one before us, and the Mu'asirin of the Mufassirin, more than 380 Mufassir. 380 Mufassir. And what I know, 50 books of Tafsir. 50 books of Tafsir. This is what I know, what I read. Between Ba'a al-Shi'a, al-Abadiyya, al-Tahririyya, al-Salafiyya, too many groups, al-Ash'ariyya, al-Mu'tazila. There are too many, like Imam al-Zajjaj, al-Mu'tazil, مثلا يعني. If you took the methods of the Mufassirin, the ways of the Mufassirin, there are too many. And subhanAllah, may Allah يعني, give them rahmah. Everybody, he used to serve his mu'taqad and his group and his way while he's making tafsir. You don't know that. For example, Imam al-Zajjaj was Mu'tazili. If you look to the between the lines while he's making tafsir, he was serving his mu'taqad. He was not serving Islam or tafsir. I can claim that. But for example, Imam al-Tabari, he's the head, he's the best tafsir. This is tafsir bil-ma'thur. Tafsir bil-ma'thur, whatever Allah said. And Rasulullah, and the Sahaba, and the Tabi'in. That's it. Ma'thur, what, you know, he cannot, you know, pretend and say anything from his mind. same thing ابن كثير. ابن كثير تفسير من المأثور تو. You know there are too many تفسير ما شاء الله beautiful. الإمام الشوكاني there are too many تفسير. You know الحمد لله. ف there are too many. ف the point here you have to know after the اسماء الله the names of Allah the attributes of Allah whatever Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in the Quran from the stories of the سابقين before and what can happen in the future and in the present time too. This is very important. For example, Quran talking about الوعد والوعيد. He promised the mu'mineen Jannah and he threatened the kuffar with hellfire. He's talking about Jannah and Nar and he's talking about the, all of that stuff. We have to know about this very important, you know. Also, number three, العلم بما أمر الله به من الأمور المتعلقة بالجوارح. For example, now Quran talking about the الجوارح. الجوارح means about إيه, like the, your heart, your sight, your hand, your whatever. And talking about the action, your action. You know, like salah, like zakah, like all of that. You have to know all of this stuff. And this is very important. بعض الناس, some people, subhanAllah, they misunderstand. يغلطون في المسائل. For example, الشيخ ابن تيمية said here, they said, some people, they memorize the Quran, but they are not following it. And some people, they doesn't memorize the Quran, but they have iman. Which one is better? The one he knows ilm and he's not following it, or the one his ilm is little but he has iman. The one has iman. And I will give you the hadith right now. Let's read this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مثل المؤمن الذي يقرأ القرآن مثل الأترجة طعمها طيب وريحها طيب. The example of the mu'min, the believer who recites the Quran like الأترجة. الأترجة some kind of fruit. It is a lot in Saudi Arabia. You know الأترجة مسلمان. عمرك ما أكلت الأترج؟ yeah. Something like شفتكم متر كده but has good smell, very sweet and has good smell. It's a fruit. The mu'min which is here recite the Quran like that, the taste of it beautiful like this for this fruit and has good smell يعني inside and outside. And they said ومثل المؤمن الذي لا يقرأ القرآن مثل التمرة طعمها طيب ولا ريح له. And the mu'min, the example of the mu'min who did not recite the Quran like the date. That has a taste, but no reek, no smell. Do you smell anything in the tongue? Date? Just sweet, but no smell. Like the mu'min who did not recite the Quran. He's still mu'min, alhamdulillah, but he has no smell, you know? Because he's not reciting the Quran. And they said, وَمَثَلُ الْمُنَافِقُ الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنَ كَمَثَلِ الرَّيْحَانَةِ رِيحَهَا حُلُو أو ريحها طيب وطعمها مر. ده منافق, the hypocrite, the one who is reciting the Quran but he's still منافق. See, he said his taste is sour like the flower and he has good smell because he's reciting the Quran but he's منافق. But inside he's sour like the ريحانه, like the flower. You know, if you eat any flower, do you see people eating flower or smell it? Smell it because it has smell, but you eat it, you will find it's murra, sour, it's bad, you know, subhanAllah. And they said, وَمَثَلُ الْمُنَافِقِ, the example of the munafiq, hypocrite, which is he's not reciting the Quran like الحنظلة, طعمها مر ولا ريح لها. You know الحنظلة? هذا التين الشوكي, بيسموه إيش, التين الشوكي, in English. You know that...
Cactus fruit.
Okay, you know that the leaves of it, a lot of thorn in it, the munafiq, the one is not reciting the Quran. Taste is very sour and no reek, no smell. Subhanallah, this is what Rasulullah gave you an example. If a mu'min not reciting the Quran and you have munafiq, somebody munafiq, he knows knowledge and he's talking by the Quran and the deen, but he's munafiq. He's not acting, he's not following. No, that mu'min which is, he has no knowledge better than him. This is what Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said. But let's talk a little bit about the importance of knowledge and getting knowledge. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, now we're going to start with one of the Sahaba, which is, he has a lot of knowledge. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you want to study the Quran, if you want to get the Quran from one of the Sahaba or the certain Sahaba, take it from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Ubay ibn Ka'b, Zayd ibn Haritha, سالم مولى أبي حذيفة. He counts certain صحابة. You can learn the Quran from them. نكوة عبد الله بن مسعود سيد: ليس العلم بكثرة الرواية ولكن العلم الخشية، أخرجه الطبراني. سيد العلم knowledge it is not because you're saying Allah said and Allah said and Allah said you talking too much to people. العلم means الخشية، to have fear of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. More you have the fear of Allah in your heart, this is العلم. You're gonna benefit from your knowledge. It is not just by talking. That's why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا، beneficial knowledge. If you did not get benefit from your knowledge, that knowledge is gonna hurt you. Yeah. Also عن أبي البختري قال: صاحب سلمان الفارسي رجل من بني عبس. سلمان الفارسي، you know سلمان صحابي، who was walking going somewhere with a man from بني عبس, the tribe of بني عبس. You know بني عبس